My name is Michael Akins. We're in the biology department at Drexel University in the Papadakis Integrated Sciences building. So my lab studies how the brain changes in response to interactions with the environment and how these go, these changes are misregulated in autism models like Fragile X syndrome. So we study a disease called Fragile X syndrome, and this is the most common form in humans of autism, with the goal one day, hopefully, of developing therapies, or research at least influencing the development of therapies that might help these patients. I was born in California, grew up in a military family, one of seven kids, so we moved around a little bit. My life was spent on the East Coast. So I've always really enjoyed wanting to know not just how something happens, but really trying to understand the whys underneath it. When I was young, this led to just sort of exploring the woods around the house. That curiosity of why things are happening, that carries over into how I also look at the brain. The motivation for me to get into this line of research was an interest in the basic science, the trying to understand how different neurons talk to each other and how they change how they talk to each other over time. And that was the question that really grabbed my interest. And then it became clear that this is something that is not working quite right in the autistic brain and in the Fragile X brain. The overall mission of our lab is to understand how, when something happens to you, so you have an experience as an individual, there's something that happens in the brain that changes how you respond to future events. And a lot of that has to do with changing how the proteins that are in the neurons. And so we're trying to understand those changes. And that's my mission in this, is to hopefully understand that at the basic level and really to understand how the brain works, but also to hopefully someday understand how these processes that we're studying in the normal brain, how they go awry in the autistic brain. Curing autism would be fantastic. Some of these patients are more or less fine, but some are really severely impacted with inability to communicate via language or recurrent seizures that affect them on a regular basis. And I think those are the aspects that we'd like to help with. Every day, if I can, I walk through the lab and I talk to people and see how their experiments are going and try to help them if they've gotten stuck and participate in that aspect of the discovery process. The thing that I love most about the job and about science in general is the discovery process, the fact that you get to look at something that maybe a million people have looked at before, but you're going to look at it in a different way, and you're going to ask a question that no one's asked before to try to learn more about that. There's this interesting aspect where you get to pick the question, right? So you get to decide what it is that interests you, and you then have to go, you have to convince other people that it's interesting, but there's a level of control but also engagement that comes from being the one deciding the problem that you're working on. It's one that motivates you, because deep down at its very core, it's something that just really, really excites you, that we're going to learn hopefully in my lab details of how the brain works that people aren't doing, and that's what excites me.